Hi, my name is Lionel Aubert, I'm French. I was married with a Congolese woman, and in 2008, my daughter-in-law were told to have been kidnapped in Congo. My family and I paid $40,000 ransom and to get the child, the 10-year-old child free. So everything seemed to be okay. At this moment, in 2008, I complained about to the French authorities for any inquiry. But what I didn't know that they were refused. In fact, before paying that, we have been waiting 3 weeks before paying the ransom. And during this time, any inquiry could have shown us that we know the people who have been involved with that. And in fact, the money wouldn't have been paid. But I didn't know that. And 6 months later, also in 2008, the French police decided to end the and they inquire. They haven't done anything, and they wouldn't do anything anymore. But we didn't know that. In 2012, I found some new elements about the kidnapping. I bring the elements to the police and to the prosecutor, and in fact. But the problem was that these new elements show that the police hasn't done the job in 2008. And if this job has been done, we wouldn't have paid the ransom because we couldn't know who has done that. The police and the prosecutor also, they didn't like this situation because that shows a lack of the administration. What they decided they sent me a convocation to the police station, and there were a woman, a police woman, who told me that if I go on this case, I will risk to go to jail. And she told me exactly that I will get between 6 months and 5 years of jail if I go on for about this case. That means the French police ask the victims I insist. In 2008, my family and I have paid $40,000 ransom. Now, I ask for justice, and the police tell me, Mr. Aubert, shut up, or you will risk to go to jail. I was upset with this situation. I am victim, and the police and the prosecutor tell me to shut up. I cannot do anything except, I don't know. 1 year later, I go on slowly. Sometimes I wrote letters. And I wrote letters to the Ministry of Justice. One man answered me, but that was a kind of a fake answer. I follow this advice, but nothing happens. Later, I called this man at the Ministry of Justice. That was in 2014, and I explained him the situation, and I showed him the points of the policeman who was decided to stop any inquiry. And I asked him, how can I complain against this policeman, if that's the prosecutor who asked the police to make me pressure to shut up about this this case. The this man at the police at the Ministry of Justice told me that he will wrote me an answer. I've never received any answer, any letter, except the man who went in my home, breaking my lock. What I know, that was on April 2014. It was on Sunday. I was sitting on my in my home, and then the door was broke. That was a big noise. A man barged in my home. I saw him. He was in my hall, and then he turned and went out. I also went out of my room, my home. In the street, he was a part of a four people group, and in front of my house, in a car, there were two other people. In this car, has a license plate from police. It was an administrative license plate. In France, some vehicles, when they are owned by the police, have a few numbers, and then at the last is a letter, A letter, and I saw that. There were two plainclothes policemen in the car. I asked them. I told them my door was broke. There were men barging in and going out. And what happened? The police, the policemen told me there were nothing. There were nothing, Mr. Over. So on Sunday there were two policemen in front of my door. My door was broke. A man went out, went in my house, went out, and then, and there were nothing. The police hasn't see anything. And my question: what were these two policemen doing outside, just outside of my home? I said they were supervising the operation. Because of my case, and I dislike it, they make me under pressure, and they want me to stop and don't talk about anymore this ransom in 2008. You can help me by sharing this video. Perhaps that's something to do, or thumb up, something like that. Thanks a lot. Goodbye.